Hi, I'm Meredydd, and today we're going to show you how to use encrypted storage for sensitive information with Anvil's App Secrets service. Web applications frequently need to store information like database passwords, authentication for other services, or sensitive personal information. Anvil can store this information encrypted, so it's not visible in your source code and can't be used outside your app. Let's start with a simple example. I'm writing an app that uses the GitHub API. It needs access to my GitHub account, but I don't want my GitHub password or authentication token sitting around in my source code for everyone to see. So we'll store it encrypted. First, I'll build our application. I'll put a panel here and put a label on it to display how many repositories I have. Now we'll fetch that information from GitHub. We'll do this in a server function to keep it private from the browser. We'll use the anvil.http module to fetch the data from the GitHub REST API. And now, in the form code, we'll call that server function and display the result. Now, this is all pretty straightforward, but my password is still in the clear here. Anyone looking over my shoulder can see it, as could anyone else on my team who can access this app. So we'll store it encrypted using the App Secrets service. I'll add this service to my app, and then create a new secret called GitHub password. Now I'll set its value. Okay, so back in the code, we don't have to have this password in our source code anymore. Instead, we just call anvil.secrets.getSecret GitHub password. And that's how to store an encrypted secret in Anvil. For the second part of this demo, I'm going to show you how to store user data encrypted in your apps. We're going to make a simple encrypted notepad. It has just one data table, with one column and one row to store the encrypted text. We'll add the secrets service, and this time we add an encryption key. We'll make a server module with two functions, one to save the secret text and one to load it. To save the text, we get the one and only row from the secret data table, or add a new one if it's empty. Then we use anvil.secrets.encrypt with key to encrypt the text before we store it. To load the secret, we do the same thing in reverse. We get the row from the table, and provided there is one, we call anvil.secrets.decrypt with key to get the plain text back. Now we've done the encryption and decryption, the client side is easy. We'll want a text area for our secret message, and a button to save it. When we open the form, we'll call that server function to load the secret from the data table. And when we click the Save button, we'll pass the new text to the server function to save it. And there we have it, an encrypted notepad. When I enter some text, it gets saved on the server. But if we look at the data table, we see nothing but encrypted nonsense. Of course, if I run the app again, it decrypts the data and displays the plain text. And that's how to store encrypted data with Anvil. For more details about the App Secrets service, check out its section in the Anvil manual. See you next time!